Let's continue with our series of STA, and today we're going to take a look at the host operation in the fabric inside the subnet. So we're going to use this topology. Let's take a quick look before we start the packet walk. So we have edge switch A and edge switch B with respective RLOC IP addresses on the loopback, and edge switch A has a host A connected with IP address of 10.10.10.1 with MAC address of A, and switch B has the host connected with IP address of 10.10.10.2, MAC address B, both within the same subnet. The both edge switches are connected to the control plane node, and control node is the LISP control node, and that's where the, as we discussed in the previous host registration video, how the LISP registration works. We can see that the control node has entries for LISP entries for both host A and host B's IP address and corresponding MAC addresses, and the control plane node has a loopback address listed in this topology. So let's take a look and look at the packet walk and how the process works. First of all, host A is going to send the ARP request for the host B. Fact that IP over Ethernet works using ARP, so host A is going to look for the MAC address of host B. This ARP request is intercepted by the edge A, specifically by the LISP process on the edge A. Edge A then asks the control plane node for the requested mapping of the MAC B's IP address to its MAC address. We know that the LISP control server knows the entries for all the MAC to IPs inside the fabric registered by the edge nodes already. Now, fabric control plane looks up endpoints B's IP address in its LISP address table. This table is similar to ARP table, but it's more in a LISP format. The fabric control plane then sends this MAC address to fabric edge A in the LISP reply. Now you see, soon as the edge A receives the information, first of all, it stores this mapping in the local ARP cache and then queries again to the fabric control plane for the location of endpoints B's MAC address. So this time edge A is asking control plane, I know that's the B's MAC address, I know its IP address, but where it lives, it's asking for the RLOC, for the location of the host B. Now the fabric control plane responds to fabric edge with the RLOC address of endpoint where host B lives, and that is a fabric edge B. You see, after edge A has got the information, edge A then encapsulates the ARP request in the VXLAN. So putting the VXLAN header outside the Ethernet, original Ethernet header, fabric edge B A then sends a packet straight across to B's VTAP address, which is a loopback address on the edge B, as the destination over the IP network. So fabric edge B then receives the VXLAN packet, takes the outer IP header away, and then removes the VXLAN header. What it sees inside the original Ethernet header, that tells edge B that the packet belongs to host B. And edge B then sends that packet across to the host B. So this is how communication works in the SDA within the subnet. I hope that video has been helpful, and I look forward to see you in one of my next videos in this series. Thank you for watching.